What's up everybody, welcome all to Linux Crypto. I hope you're all doing great and welcome back to this video in which we're doing another analysis on the new Luna, so not Luna Classic, the new Luna, and excuse me for the logo, which is still from the old Luna, I think, but the new logo is nowhere to be found. So enough rambling. But yeah, so I wanted to do a quick analysis on Luna because we covered it 2 days ago and I still think it is, I know that quite a lot of people invested in it. I mean, it's a 1.8 billion market cap as of right now, which I did not expect, or I kind of feared it, to be honest. Not necessarily didn't expect it, but I thought it would be possible, but I hoped it would be a little bit lower. Just no hate towards Terra or its holders, but I just think it deserved to like get a little bit less of a market cap and actually prove that it has changed and that it is a very good project. But yeah, still I know a lot of people invested in it, including some of you, or at least some of you are looking at it, so I thought it would be interesting. I mean, apart from all of that, it is interesting, and the volume right now is almost at a billion, which is quite high. But volume or the market cap at 1.8 billion, as I said, which places it at around like 36, 37, 30, 38, that level, which is pretty high, I think. But apart from that, let's actually get into the analysis, because it's actually pretty interesting what's happening with the price as well. Overall, what happened yesterday, we're still on the 15-minute time frame, which is shameful, I know. 15-minute time frame is not ideal to work with, but the 1 hour time frame, there's just not enough of price action yet, I think, and on the 15-minute, we can actually see some more things. So excuse me for that, but I think this is better. So what we see and what we had yesterday, obviously yesterday we had quite a bullish day, and we also had that breakout with Bitcoin towards the end of the evening, somewhere around here. So that made Luna go all the way up to $12 at a top. $12 was quite a strong resistance level, it seems. After that, we got into this small downtrend, as you can see. But something, the interesting thing I saw is that we actually got this like more long-term uptrend going on. With, I mean, you often see that with the last touch of a trend line like this, you get a bull run like that. If we can call this a bull run, I mean, it was from the bottom to the top. It was 86%. Yeah, that's a bull run. So now the most important thing is that these two are going to clash, because you got this downtrend, which I think is going to hold. And if it's not going to hold, that's great as well. But it is looking pretty strong. But we are going to reach this level right here between $7.5 and $7. And that's a very important level. That's a very strong level. First of all, you got that trend line. You got the 200 EMA. 7.5 is a psychological support level. You also got this FIB here at the 382 and a regular key level. All in all, it's a really strong level, if that wasn't clear to you yet. So I think actually that we are going to continue this downtrend we have right now. I mean, you could arguably say that we're doing something like this and that maybe this is going to hold, but I doubt it. It is possible, but I really doubt it. I think the price is going to drop down to this level, and what happens at this level is the most interesting part. Because basically two things can happen. And sorry if this video is a little bit long, I was rambling a little too much maybe, but let's just get to the end of it right now. So we will definitely find some support off of this level, but this level has to actually provide us enough support within the next hours after touching that to actually get above, I would say, this level right here. This level right here between 8.65 and $9. If this level actually gets us above $9, I think we can have another bull run like this. Maybe a little bit less. Obviously, we're coming from a higher level, so it's less percentage. But I think we can actually get that move again up towards 11.5. And 11.5 would be my first price target. It's at this point of time, the markets are too unstable and volatile, and definitely Luna at this point of time, it's too volatile to actually. I mean, I think that with a real bull run, which is still possible, I think we could reach something like $16. That's the next major resistance in the case of a real bull run. So like multiple hundred percentages, which is possible even in these markets, because we have a little bit more of bullish momentum throughout the last 2 days. And apart from that, I think a coin like Luna, at this point of time, a lot of people are looking at it. It has a lot of volume, it has a track record. I think it could definitely do that. Whether that's deserved or not, we're not going to get into that. So that's one thing that could happen. Find support off of that level between $7.5 and $7. That's the most important part to remember, and get above $9. If, however, we find support there and we reject off of that level, then I think we're just going to continue going down. And this level here between 6.5 and $7 could actually be strong enough support to let us consolidate for a little bit. But if we're consolidating on top of that level, so we don't have that breakout soon, so within hours of touching that level, it's going to be really first of all, it will be very hard to predict, but something like this will become way less likely, and something like this becomes way more likely. So then you would argue that the sellers are actually stronger than the buyers, and that we would have a move like this. And what happens from there? I will probably update Luna tomorrow as well, just to keep the updates fresh and to keep the analysis fresh, because a lot is happening throughout Luna right now, and it's just crazy. So yeah, that's basically my analysis. Again, excuse me that the video was a little bit long, but I just wanted to cover everything. So thank you all for watching and listening, and I hope to see you all in my next videos. Bye.